side right now, and I just wanted to tell you the schedule a little bit. After this, we're all going to go to 1080 for the master class and for the rest of the day. And if you don't know where that room is, follow the college students. And college students, make sure that you see if everyone gets to that room. Fabulous. Excellent. Well, you are in for a treat. Meredith Height Estevez is just wonderful. I am so enjoying working with her. She's been working with my students yesterday, and this is your chance to work with her today. You can read about all of the amazing, wonderful things that she has done in the program, certainly played in all sorts of places, done teaching all sorts of places. What I particularly appreciate about her is her focus on bringing joy to the art of performing, and it has truly been a joy to work with her. So, enjoy.
My specialty, my passion project, to repurpose vocal music and string music for oboe. And so the set of songs that you're about to hear come from different countries, from different nationalities. They're all pretty much from the same late 1800s to early to mid 1900s. And they're all, the thing they have in common is they're all about the evening or the night. And so I know it's 1 p.m., but if you can close your eyes and imagine each one. The Clara Schumann song that we're going to begin with, the poem that the singer sings, talks about what it's like to walk by the home of a beloved around dusk. The second song is a lullaby originally written for violin and piano by French composer Lily Boulanger. The Barber Shore on the Shining Night is probably one of my favorite pieces for in vocal music. Samuel Barber loved the oboe. He wrote many solos in his vocal music, but also in his symphonies. And he had a story that I love to share with audiences because it's not something a lot of people know about. And many people don't know the struggles that Samuel Barber had to find joy and to feel well as a composer and as a musician. And so when I read about his struggles with alcoholism and depression, it was inspiring to me as an educator and a musician to bring awareness to the ways that we don't always take care of ourselves as musicians and as artists. And so Shore on the Shining Night is an example of how Barber is excellent at capturing something, so the fleeting beauty of being alive. And lastly, the Debussy Bonsoir, which translates to mean beautiful evening, is a two-minute song that encapsulates a whole. So I hope you enjoy my little made-up song cycle about the evening.
Thank you.
I love speaking about burnout because a lot of times artists, especially, and especially musicians, forget that one thing that heals burnout is to creatively play. And so I love to remind people that play is really important. Even though we're really serious about the music and the reeds and all the things we're trying to learn as oboists, it's important to remember to play. And that's what the next piece I'm going to play for you is all about. It is called Blues for Dee Dee, and the Dee Dee stands for Diana Doherty, who is the principal oboist of the Sydney Symphony. And she wrote to her friend, who is a composer, and said, "I want to play jazz. So can you write me something that sounds like it's being improvised?" And so this is where the Blues for Dee Dee came. Hopefully it'll be playful for you, and I'm going to try to have a mindset of play, but it's actually really tricky, and there are a lot of really fast notes, but it is really fun to do pitch bending and fun rhythms, and of course we have a real live jazz pianist here, and so we'll be performing Blues for Dee Dee now. Thank you.
Thank you.
to Kansas State University, so look her up if you don't know her music. She's written so much great stuff. Baroque invention is a play on words. The form of the invention is a Baroque form, usually a two-part, three-part. So it's really polyphonic, meaning multiple independent voices, and it's a lot of fun to play. So thank you again for having me, and please enjoy Alyssa Morris, Baroque Invention. I'm missing a page for my music, so one second.
So, anyone know any good jokes, or?
No voice doesn't take to change a light bulb.
Oh, okay. For the live stream, how many oboists does it take to change a light bulb?
Seven.
Apparently one, because couldn't figure out they had to push the buttons in the Rausch lobby and not slide them up.
What?
I don't have it memorized, sorry.
Can't believe it.
Ready?
Thank you. if my students could help and set up some chairs, that would be